Yeah.
Cool. Where you wanna be at? You gonna stay out here?
I'm gonna just stay right here.
Okay.
And so, do I need to be inside?
No, you good.
Okay.
What's the man behind the curtain gonna do?
Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain.
Yeah, what's he doing?
He's gonna be a man in the controls.
So he can manipulate the camera from
yes.
there?
Mm-hmm.
My
mm-hmm.
technology's changed since 1986. Okay, now what is bad?
Good.
Okay.
Alright, here we go. In 3, 2, 1.
Hello, my name is Jessica Richardson, and this is what the Breathing Association means to me. It was an hour of testing for sure when I, as a single mother and a newly divorced single mother, experienced a substantial decrease in my household income. Basically, I just didn't have the money. I didn't have the money to pay my utility bill when it came current. Just the memory of opening up my AEP bill and seeing those words in bold, dark print, disconnection notice, a shot of fear went through my entire being, and I was in a place of fear and disbelief, and just really was wondering how am I going to pay this? How, you know, I started making phone calls, but the glimmer of light in that hour of struggle and darkness was the Breathing Association, and that is just maybe a tiny bit of the bigger picture of what led to the journey of getting my household back in order, self-sufficiency, and not having to worry about coming home to a dark and cold house, and not having to worry my child, my daughter, her coming home and having security, comfort. All the things we're supposed to do to protect our children. The Breathing Association was my salvation in that hour. So,
Jessica, what would have happened? What would you have had to do to get the money to get the gas and the electricity back on?
Well, providing I could bake maybe like, 50 pies between that moment in time and 5 days from then, I don't know. I really don't know. Resort to beggary, go knocking on doors.
Do you know any other women or colleagues that have been in the same situation?
I have a few friends that also have benefited from the services that the Breathing Association offers. We sometime would go together. We would help one another in that plight, in that struggle, and maintaining our household overhead. So I, for one, can testify that the Breathing Association, they are needed. They are a needed presence in our community. I'm a witness to the power of helping people and meeting them at their need, right where they're at. The Breathing Association did that for me.
So something that we like to pride ourselves on is that we help people. We take the pressure off paying the bill, so that you can focus on you, so our recipients can focus on working, on being well, on
getting on with life.
Getting on with life, and so that we are not that we don't have the same clients over and over again, that you're able to use services and then move past that.
Right.
So can you maybe talk about how the Breathing Association has, getting that hand up has helped you provide for other things in your home, such as good food, such as clothing, good food, clothing, things that you
balancing need. The budget and the bottom line. The Breathing Association helped me in terms of not enabling me, but more empowering me to keep a certain momentum going in my household. In life happens. It's important that we maintain a balance. I have to say, for more reasons than one, my child, my children, my family is the priority, the number one priority for me to do that. And they help me keep a certain standard for my children to see in me for the long run, so they can progress in life and not be burdened or saddled with anxieties of not having enough. Just being worried overall and things like that. I don't want it to play out into other parts of our lives. Say, for instance, in their schooling, I want them to have 100% focus on their school books, on their school studies, and where they're going to go to college, and not, how are we going to make it this month? Is there going to be enough food on the table? Mom had to take that money and pay that bill with that. That for me is the number one concern, maintaining that balance in the household and engaging, keeping that lifestyle standard maintained as we go forward. And
so
that is what the Breathing Association.
Can you take what you just said and condense it? Like when we first met, you came in and said, having the electricity bill paid for meant that I was not worried about keeping the lights on at home and passing that tension to my children. I need my children to be able to thrive and not be worried about the house. You said something
to that.
But like, take what you just said and can you
bring it in?
Bring it in.
Yes. Having the burden released from having the burden released from the utility bills being reduced for me through the Breathing Association's offering and services, I want to say succinctly, there is a program known as the PIP program. That program is regulated through the state. And they are one of the top contenders, I should say the top contender, in accessing certain funds to help people in certain situations in a financial struggle to keep their utilities at a minimum amount per month. Making sure that I didn't pass on that worry or anxiety to my daughter was so important to me. The Breathing Association helped me not have to do that, because they gave me, there was an option that was available, and that option helped me maintain a peace, and that peace transmitted throughout my entire household, where my daughter didn't have to pick up on any uncertainty. That's a huge, huge asset and benefit of the Breathing Association. In times like these, and we're facing some uncertain times, the Breathing Association took that uncertainty away for me. They took that burden off of my shoulders so that I could breathe better. No pun intended, but yes, that is exactly what I think about when I hear the name the Breathing Association.
Can you say something
having stability in our home, energy. Having stability in our home energy helps us breathe easier. Thank you to the Breathing Association.
Casey, what else do we need to...
I think you hit a lot of good points.
Okay.
Yeah. Understood that there have been situations where people have to cut corners in one way to make ends meet on the other.
Okay.
Okay. So maybe specifically, I've understood that people have ended up selling their food stamps.
Okay.
That their SNAP benefits
mm-hmm.
at a reduced rate to be able to pay for the electricity, which then adds to food insecurity in the home.
Robbing Peter to pay Paul.
Can you speak to that? Not necessarily in your situation, but you know for other people
uh-huh.
that they've had to.
Okay.
Because for people who don't understand
mm-hmm.
what it's like to hit rough times,
okay,
they don't understand that $200 for the gas bill means that we eat ramen noodles for the month. Like, there just isn't that, there's no relation between having energy security and food security.
Okay? Right.
So can you help tie that together?
Okay. I'm going to try.
And do you know about this? Like, how the robbing Peter to pay Paul?
Yes.
And do you have any examples of it, of stories that you've heard?
Yes. I know, and please appreciate the candor and transparency in this moment. I just want to express emphatically how, when you have a deficit in your household pertaining to a loss or a threat of loss of a utility, I live in Franklin County, so AEP is our number one provider for energy source. And when you have a balance that comes due, $200 as opposed to, I should say, and you have a supplement also that you're managing for food in your household, you have an instant situation for a setup for disaster. Or again, without having the option and the knowledge of a organization that can shoulder that burden and bring a balance to a scenario such as having a $200 disconnect notice from your energy provider versus we're going to eat ramen noodles for this month. If I take this money and put it on this one bill. Have you ever heard the term paying, robbing Peter to pay Paul, or the opposite? That's pretty much what you have in a nutshell for a situation or a particular household that is really on the edge of teetering from having a roof over their heads to almost a homeless situation. It's just, it could happen just like that. Being on the edge to pay a bill versus food or even your rent payment. So again, the Breathing Association truly is an added strength to a household circumstance such as that.
So many great points that you've made, and I'm going through what you've said.
Okay.
If
stability.
We are able to bring it.
I want to say a key word.
Can you think three key words?
Okay.
Your whole experience with the Breathing Association.
Okay.
With your background. Just three
Yeah.
To
okay. Stability, security, confidentiality. Three tiers or three pillars that when I hear the word, or when I think of the Breathing Association, I think of stability, security, and confidentiality. The staff and the faculty on hand that greet you and meet you when you're coming in, they treat you like an entire person. They sit down, they're very personable with you, patient. Everything's very organized. Stability. I want to talk about stability because it covers such a grave range when it comes to anyone's household. I think people can relate to that term in more ways than one. Stability for the fact that you will be able to stay in your home. You will not have to leave or go elsewhere to find comfort or warmth. Security in knowing that you have your own. And then confidentiality, again, you feel safe in sharing some really dark moments with the person that takes all your story into consideration and why you need this particular assistance. Well, I hope to become a broadcast reporter, actually. yes, truthfully. It's kind of organic. I have a dream to tell the 6 o'clock news one day. So you just never know who you're going to meet and whom the Breathing Association is reaching out to. All walks of life. The diversity of people that I've met personally in coming to the Breathing Associations has really expanded my perspective on the caricature or what a person in need. You never know what a person in need looks like. It kind of removes all the stigma and the barriers and the blinders off of who would need help from the Breathing Association. You asked me something else. I was
what about your situation now? How are you doing now?
Okay, since I got that PIP adjustment, everything is coming up roses. Thank you, Breathing Association. Okay.
Were you using social services before?
Yes. How I came in contact initially with the Breathing Association and their services. Once upon a time, I was my father's caregiver for a period of 3.5 years. And in that time period, everything I had to really be mindful to monitor and manage every single cent that came in the house. Being his caregiver also included managing being his caregiver also included me managing his income as well. So everything had to be thoroughly adjusted and regimented on a daily level. Daily, everything had to be thoroughly regimented and monitored. There was very little room in the budget for superfluous expenditures or just like go to the store and just buy something on a whim. So the Breathing Association helped me in that budget, the daily budgeting of my household, wherein they actually had set up for me a budget on pay paper on how to best, I would say, audit my my everything from my grocery bill to, of course, my utility bills, and even gas to drive my father back and forth to his doctor appointments. So there were quite a few bonuses in coming in contact with the Breathing Association and making sure that our air was managed to that degree. Everything coincided with just one introductory meeting with the people at the Breathing, the counselors at the Breathing Association. The counselors at the Breathing Association.
Caseworkers. Caseworkers at the Breathing Association.
Okay.
Yes.
The caseworkers. The caseworkers at the Breathing Association.
I didn't know they'll set you up on budget.
Yeah.
You
yeah, okay. Yeah, that was what my first initial introduction was when
so
I first
they helped you get the electricity bill under wraps and sort of like, here's the number of monies that you have and here's where you can put them.
Right, right.
Okay. Well, that's cool. Mm-hmm. I didn't know. Mm-hmm. Okay. That's
okay.
Cool.
I just want to say. No, you're fine. You were going to say something.
Did they connect you with any other social services, like with Food Pantry or Center for New Directions or Dress for Success?
Oh, what a wonderful syndicate of resources and extended resources that I came in contact and knowledge with as well. In coming into the Breathing Association and meeting with the caseworkers there who are so personable and friendly to me. I just want to say off the top of my head, Dress for Success was also a friend of theirs. It's like, I want to say like a, kind of like a tight friend to friend association, organization, type of syndicate?
Collaboration.
Okay.
That's what I was gonna say.
It's a community collaborative.
Collaboration.
Okay. Mm-hmm. A community collaboration of friends, of resources. A community collaboration of resources is what I was in for once the door was open to me through the Breathing Association, where I was able to connect with other organizations that can help me entirely throughout my household. Everything from food pantries to organizations that that help fit me for the workplace, for going forward with my career. And I just have to say, it all worked out for the good in the end. A bad situation seemed like it was my lemonade moment. So it was my lemonade moment. I had lemons, and because of the Breathing Association, I made lemonade. And how sweet it is. Okay, okay.
She is a perfect girl.
Yeah, I don't think we have anything. You got anything else in there?
I can only be as good as the production.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, I feel like you have another thought in your head, don't you?
Well, I just know that when we met, we kind of got teary-eyed.
Mm-hmm.
When I started to share with you about the stability, about the security factor, about the fact that I didn't have to dwell in uncertainty, that there was a bright light, the bright light.
The conversation is really candid, and just you were panicked, and you were set on your hind end.
Yes.
You didn't know where you were going. You didn't know what was going on, except that the electricity was going to get cut off.
Right. It's one.
And you're trying to be strong for your daughter.
Right. Right.
And so this.
And I get this. I get this invoice in the mail, and it says disconnect notice, and I'm like, I just made rent.
Yeah.
not one thing, it's another. And I'm like, okay, Lord, how are we gonna do this? And I've gone through some spells of depression, I have to be honest. Since my father, I mentioned my initial introduction to the Breathing Association was in a time when I was my father's caregiver, and I had to be very mindful and very responsible and a great steward of every cent that came in the house, resource-wise. Everything was regimented. We knew where it was going, when it was going, and if something was over or awry, it stuck out like a sore thumb. And after my father passed away, I went through. I experienced a bit of homelessness, and after I came through that time in my life, I actually went through a really, really dark night of depression, and I am kind of like not in acknowledgement of it. I didn't broadcast it or anything like that, but the symptoms and the signs were there. And with that, I did fall behind in a few things, activities that needed to be done in the household, but because of the heaviness of that moment in my life, and the depression was such a heavy, heavy season, it's a heavy period in my life, that some things did lax and they did lapse. And that's how I had to get readjusted to what is known as the PIP adjustment program, and get reacquainted with the Breathing Association services as well. I want to say that the Breathing Association, they didn't enable me, but they helped me regroup and get back on track to what mattered. And they took and alleviated that burden of making sure that the energy was going to continue, that the electric was going to continue, that the gas was going to stay on. That took a huge burden off of my shoulders, because the income just wasn't there. It just wasn't there. And another worry of that magnitude probably would have made all the difference in my subsiding back into depression and just hopelessness, just like it's like a spirit, and it's like a goblin. Depression is like another level of hell, and I wouldn't wish that on my worst enemy. So if the Breathing Association could actually impact how a person is feeling to the degree of the psychological and mental health, in addition to what they already provide, which is a quality of breathing. Can you do that with me? Just breathe. The Breathing Association, that's what they do. They bring that kind of relief to just a common person that is out there just living their life, and who wants their breath taken away from them? Nobody. Thank you, Breathing Association. Okay. I think we got something. Okay.
I think you did it, sis. I think we got a lot. I would love to put like a wig on you.
And don't you do it at all. But let me tell you, this side of you is pretty sharp now.
Okay.